Hello everyone.
Hello, Master.
I'm so happy to have this time to share the word of God with all of you. Let us pray and we begin. Dear our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. Lord, we tend to fall in the flesh whenever we are just left. But Lord, now you have prepared this chance so that Lord you can fellowship with you. Just like the vehicle needs fuel to move. In the same way also we need the strength of your work so that you can move forward in our spiritual life. Father, allow all followers to realize your heart through this word. And please lead us to faith in believing in Jesus rather than believing in ourselves. Father, we thank you. Guide us up to the end. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. We're going to read the book of Numbers chapter 21. So please open your Bibles in the book of Numbers chapter 21 starting from verse
4.
Starting from verse 4. So we'll share the words up to verse
9.
If you are there, we will read Numbers chapter 21, verse 4 up to verse
9.
Then they journeyed from Mount Har by the way of the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom. And the soul of the people became very discouraged on the way. And the people spoke against God and against Moses. Why have you brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and water, and our soul loathes this worthless bread.
Abantu bavuga Imana na Mose nabi bati mwadukuriye iki muri Egiputa mukatuzana gupfira mu butayu.
So the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and many of the people of Israel died. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord that He take away the serpents from us."
Basanga Mose baramubwira bati wakoze icyaha kuko twavuze Uwiteka nawe nabi saba Uwiteka adukuremo izi nzoka. Mose arabasabira.
So Moses prayed for the people. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Make a fiery serpent and set it on a pole. And it shall be that everyone who is bitten, when he looks at it, shall live." So Moses made a bronze serpent and put it on a pole, and so it was. If a person had bitten anyone, if the serpent had bitten anyone, when he looked at the bronze serpent, he lived.
Mose acura inzoka miringa imanika ku giti kibendera wo inzoka yariye yarebe iyo nzoka y'umuringa gakira.
Yes, thank you. We have read up to verse 9.
Nakoze dusomye kugeza ku murongo wa 9.
So there is one famous artist who lived long time ago.
Ari umuhanzi wabayeho kuva kera cyane.
His name was Leonardo da Vinci.
Witwaga Leonardo da Vinci.
And now this man was a very skillful artist. Not only the skills that he learned, but he had also a very great talent in like making statues, like sculptures and so on.
sibyo gusa yarafite n'impano yo gukora ibibumbano ndetse no gushanya.
So now this is a story that I heard of him.
Hello,
about him. One day as I was walking nearby the village of his neighborhood.
Mugera ari gutembera mu gace k'iwabo.
So now he was passing, you know, next to a place where there was a very big rock.
Yaratambutse ahita ahantu hari hari igitare kinini.
So then all of a sudden he stood, you know, by the way.
Rero ako kanya yahise ahagarara.
And now he began to look at one of the rock and he was staring at it.
Ako niko yatangiye kwitegereza rwa rutare twitegereza.
Now he was looking very closely to the rock.
Yarwegere ngo rurebe neza.
However, other people who are passing in the same way with him, nobody was caring about the rocks, now everybody was going their way, just passing. However, this man now couldn't keep up his journey, he just stood there for a moment and he kept staring at the rock. Now, looking at the rock itself was not surprising. But what shocked people is, even by the time they returned back to their homes, now he was still standing there, staring at the rock. Now everyone was surprised. Hey, what is wrong with you? From the morning you're just looking at the rock, even up to now. Surely the inhabitants could not understand what the man was doing.
Rero abaturage ntabwo bashaka kumenya iby'umugabo.
So until late night now he went back home.
Rero kumugoroba yasubiye mu rugo.
The next day,
umunsikurikiyeho,
now as people were going to work, once again now they were passing into the same way.
Mugihe abantu barimo bamuca bajya ku kazi baciye ahandi n'ubundi.
But again, when he arrived at the place, once again he stood and he was looking at the same rock.
Rero barageze ahandi n'ubundi yarahagaze itegereza urutare.
No one else was caring about it. Everybody was going their way to their business and nobody could, you know, care about those rocks. Strangely enough, you know, again, you know, until evening, Leonardo da Vinci was just, you know, looking at the same rock. Now people could not hold themselves, they became very curious and now they went to him. And now they began to ask him, what is special, you know, in this rock? Why are you still, you know, staring at it for 2 days? Now he began to speak to people. Hey, also you can stand and look closely to that rock. You know, if you look very carefully, you can see, you know, the angel who is confined inside of the rock. Oh, there is a beautiful angel confined in the rock. Now he can't be released from there. Don't you see him? Please look very closely. People were looking but they couldn't see anything. Now the next day, now when he came to that place, now he came with a hammer. And now different knives of, you know, artists. So he began to hit the rock and shape it. Now for some few days he was working on it, now trying to make one very beautiful statue of the angel from that rock.
Rero yamaze iminsi gwamaga iminsi ahondagura rwa rutare mu gihe gito cyane yaramaze gukuramo umumarayika mwiza cyane.
And now this is one of the famous pieces of work that Leonardo da Vinci had in his life.
Uyu ni umwe mu mirimo Leonardo da Vinci yabashije gukora mu buzima bwe.
I believe even today the same statue is, you know, in one of the very famous museums around the world.
Ntekereza ndashidikanya ko ari kimwe mu kinyabugeni kiri mu nzu ndangamurage z'isi.
But now, what I want to say is, you know, the eyes of the artist and the eyes of normal people were different.
Rero amaso y'umunyabugeni n'amaso abantu basanzwe batandukanye.
Some regular people when they looked at the rock, only they could see was the rock.
Abantu bashaka kubona basanzwe kuri rwa rutare nta kintu usibye rutare nyine.
However, in the eyes of the artist, looking at the rock, he could see something very different from what other people can see. That's why they couldn't understand what he's doing. Hey, how can you stand here for 2 days just looking and staring at the rock? However, in his eyes as an artist, he could see the beautiful angel that was confined in the rock. Everyone, so there is a difference between the eyes of normal people and the eyes of an artist. How much more different is the eyes of God from the eyes of a human being? What God sees is different from what man sees. This is what the Bible says. Now, as we're believing in God, it is very wise for us to believe in God based on what the eyes of God see. However, many people, they believe in God based on what they see with their fleshly eyes. Now, in the book of Genesis chapter 3, the Bible says that when man committed sin when he ate from the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, remember the Bible says that his eyes were opened. Which kind of eyes are those? Everyone, this is the eyes that was not opened by God. When God created us, He did not open that kind of eyes. Because the eyes that He gave us was enough. Now we can see in Genesis chapter 1 and Genesis chapter
2,
Adam and Eve, they saw what God saw.
Adam and Eva,
because they were seeing using the eyes of God. Whatever God said, now they could accept it. Also, what they could say, God could accept it. But now the problem is, by eating from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, remember the Bible says that their eyes were opened. And now when their eyes were opened, do you know the first thing they looked at? They looked at themselves. And now they realized they
are
naked. They were very shameful. And now they try to cover their nakedness with their fig leaves. Now these eyes that were opened by Satan, the first thing it was to see was I myself. Now it is the same eyes that we possess even now. Instead of looking at God, instead of looking at Jesus Christ, In faith life, all people live looking at themselves. Then what do they see? Now they see nakedness. Now that nakedness, you know, stands for sin. Why? Because nakedness, you know, caused shame. In the same way also sin causes shame. You know, sometimes you are given opportunity to speak before people. Now, when you are given a chance maybe to give a lecture or to introduce yourself before people, all over the world, regardless of who it is, people speak of their good things. It's not that in life they have only good things. Of course, everybody has weakness, have sin, and some shortcomings. But we people, we tend to hide our evil things and we just want to speak about good things. My name is so and so.
inzira byanjye niri niri
you know I have this you know education level
ati nize amashuri nayo
oh I have helped so so and so
ati nafashe abana
now people they just speak of their good aspects
usanga abantu bavuga ibyiza gusa bagize
who dares to speak about their evilness
ese ni ndo gitinyo bavuga ibibi
hey I have committed adultery
ati yewe mu ndewe ndarasamba
I have stolen the things of people
wose ni nacuce abantu ndiba
I know I'm a robber
yewe ndo mwambuzi
I'm a thief I'm a fighter
yigisambo ndirwanya
there is no one who ever like introduced themselves like that
namuntu ushobora kusobanura abandi mu rubohore
even though they have you know those weaknesses and shortcomings and sins
no ngenye nizo azifite ari byo babura n'ibyaha bifite
but sin causes us shame
ariko icyaki waterisonde
and because of that shame
cyane cyo kimwaro
we don't want to be revealed in front of people with that weakness
usanga tudashaka kugaragara imbere y'abantu mu rugo buryo
now God did not want to open that kind of eyes
rero imana se yafunguye amaso
this is why he forbade us from eating from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil
nyamwanga tumuje kurya kutari ya kugice cy'ubwenge umenyekana ishyira n'ikibi
however now we can see that now we have become already left before God We have become already naked before God.
Ero twanditsa abantu bambaye gusa imbere y'Imana.
Now in front of God, God sees everything as we are.
Imbere y'Imana turi imbere y'Imana yibona nkuko biri.
Now following what God says is very important.
Ero ukurikira iby'Imana ivuga nicyo kigenze.
Now if you follow the word of God,
ero ukurikira ijambo ry'Imana,
all of your life will change.
Ubuzima bwawe bwose buzahinduka.
Now since I became conscious in this world, I found myself going to church.
Banamenye ubwenge muri isi nisanze nyamu rusengero
I thought I'm a good Christian
Natekereza ko ndi umwizera mwiza
until the time when I realized that I'm filled with sin I'm filled with unrighteousness
Ngizige namenye ngo nuzuye gukiranirwa nuzuye ibyaha
Now one day in my former church I went to the pastor and I asked him this question very sincerely
Rusengero rwangero umunsi umwe nasanze pastor ndamubaza
Ah pastor you prayed for me
Is a pastor who aren't saying.
You remember that day, you know, I knelt down and I confessed all of my sins. Then you prayed for me and you told me that I have received salvation. But how come still I find myself committing sin? Why do I still do some, you know, crimes? Why do I break the law? I don't want to be a hypocrite. Even though recently I received salvation, but I tried to live a sinless life, but I failed. It was not easy to approach your pastor and dare ask him such kind of questions. However, because my heart was very heavy, I wouldn't just keep it within my heart. However, the answer he gave me also shocked my heart.
Do
you know what he said? I said, hey, don't worry. That's not only you. Even all of us, we are the same. So now he was referring to the congregation, now the kind of a church that we were in.
Rero yari ayitwaje mu rusengero twa turimo.
Me, even you know, all these little church leaders, all of us, we are
the same.
Yes, we receive salvation.
Yes, we are
born again.
But
still we are sinners.
We
will remain always sinners as long as we live.
So be of
courage, it is not only you.
Maybe
he thought he was strengthening
me. However,
the answer he gave me broke my heart.
Ariko gisuza mpaye cyamenye umutima wanjye.
So then I began to question myself.
Natangiye kwibazanya.
What is good in believing in God?
Ese kwizera Imana ni iki cyiza kibiri?
What is good in receiving salvation?
Ese kwakira agakiza ni iki cyiza kibiri?
If I will remain sinner all of my life.
Rero mwizera n'umunyabyaha ubuzima bwanjye bwose.
If until the day of the judgment I'm found with sin.
Kugeza ku munsi w'urubanza nsanzwe nkiri umunyabyaha.
What's the difference between before I receive salvation and after I receive salvation?
Ni leta ndukona gati mbere yuko nakira agakiza na nyuma.
I couldn't see any difference at all.
Natano kana nabashaka kubona.
However, even my spiritual guide, I'm sorry to say that, but he didn't have the clear solution to give me.
Mbare kubivuga ariko n'umubazo wanjye w'umwuka ntiyaratinyuka kubivuga.
Now, this is how we live in our life. Whenever we want to examine ourselves, we don't examine ourselves using the word of God. We examine ourselves using our eyes. And this is the eyes that were opened, you know, by the sin we did by eating the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil. Now, when Adam and Eve looked at themselves, they were very shameful. And they didn't want to stand before God. Hey, today, if you look at yourself, are you really confident to stand before
God?
Even today, if you look at yourself, you can only run away from God. Because by looking at yourself, all you can see is only sins, you know, evil things, you know, bad things, the crimes that you have committed. Now today I want to speak about, you know, the place where God wants us to look at. When you read the book of John chapter 5, now there is a story of the pool of Bethesda. One day in Israel there was a myth. There was like a false, you know, story. There was a rumor that now once in a while the angel comes down and stirs the water in the pool of Bethesda, and whosoever enters the first, they are healed of any kind of disease they have. In the Bible, we never see anyone who was ever healed by entering in the pool of Bethesda. Anyway, in the time of Jesus, there was such a myth that was going around, you know, Israel. So now, because of that, so many sick people came and they surrounded the pool of Bethesda. Do you know what they're waiting for? For the angel to come down and stir up water. There was a man who had been sick for 38 years. I don't know whether he was waiting, you know, all the 38 years, but the angel never came. However, there the story, now Jesus comes to that pool. And now we see Jesus speaking to the man who had an infirmity only for 38 years only. So now when I was listening to this story, I began to question myself. Hey, the Bible says that Jesus is the Savior. Always Jesus healed the sick. But why didn't he approach all the sick people around the Bethesda pool? Why didn't he go and speak to them? Why didn't he heal their disease? Why did he only go to speak to the man who had an infirmity for 38 years? Now, here there is something very interesting. God gave us two eyes. And these two eyes can only see in one direction. Now, here we have the pool of Bethesda. And now we have Jesus also on the other side who is coming. You cannot look at both at the same time. Either you look at the pool of Bethesda, then you turn your back towards Jesus. Or else you look at Jesus Christ, and then you turn your back towards the pool of Bethesda. You can't look at the pool of Bethesda and look at Jesus at the same time. You can see the pool of Bethesda and see Jesus at the same time. Now, why didn't Jesus go to the sick people who are surrounding the pool of Bethesda?
Yesu ategere bano bantu bari kugitendereza igitwete sida.
The only reason is one.
Mpamvu yarimwe.
All of them they are turning their backs toward Jesus.
Mpamvu nuko bose barabateye umugongo Yesu.
Because they are looking at the pool waiting for the angel to come down.
Barako bari batumbira ikidendereza bategereje ko marayika aza.
However, at the end of this story,
ero mu mpera z'inkuru,
only the man with an infirmity for 38 years was recovered from his
disease.
Among those who are surrounding the pool, no one of them could be healed. Now this is how Satan has deceived the whole world. Satan has caused people to look at themselves. And now because of that they cannot look at Jesus. And this is why they end their lives being sinners. And now their last destination is to go to hell. So loving followers, where are you looking at? Now, depending on where you are looking at, that will bring a very big difference in your life. Now, as I'm speaking of today, people they have two places to look. Either you are looking at yourself, or you're looking at Jesus. Those who are looking at Jesus, now you see how Jesus Christ must work for them. Now today we read here in the story in the book of Numbers chapter 21. The Bible says that Israelites they are on the journey from Egypt towards the country of the promise. However, the journey in the wilderness was very complicated. Because there are no roads in the wilderness. So they could be lost. One day, as they approached Mount Har, now they were surrounding and returning to the same place continuously. Now people became very tired. There was no food, no water. Now everyone was complaining to God. Everybody began to complain towards Moses. Then this is how God sent the fiery serpents. So many of them were beaten. And the Bible says that many of them also were dying. So now this is what happened a long time ago. However, there must be a reason why God wrote this story in the Bible. What is God trying to tell us? Hey, you are the people only to complain against God. In good conditions you are happy. And in the bad conditions we complain. That shows the kind of the heart we live with. So we don't have a good heart at all. Because in the good heart there can't be complaint. If human being has truly a good heart, whether you are treated well, still you will be joyful. And even if you are not treated well, because you have a good heart, then also you'll be happy. Now, however, now the people's hearts began to complain against God. And now this is how they prayed and asked God. Oh God, please take away this serpent from us. When you read here in the book of Numbers chapter 21, we can read verse 7. Therefore the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord that he may take away the serpents from us."
Now,
according to their mind, they thought if these serpents are taken away, then it can be okay. So now they
were
focusing on the ground. Every time they were very careful, vigilant to see if they cannot, step on the snake. Now their focus was always on the ground. Do you know what the ground means? In the Bible, the ground stands for we human beings. Now, to overcome, you know, the poison of snake, according to the way of man, that was looking at the ground and trying to avoid the serpents. In other words, that means, in order to overcome now the poison of sin, people, they always look at themselves. How do I live? You know, how do I behave? How do I speak to others? How do I treat others? Always their eyes, their focus are on themselves. Now, here in the wilderness, people were very busy looking at the ground. This ground stands for human flesh. As long as you're looking at it, what can you see? Only weakness. Complaints towards God. Anger. Such kind of things now they are filled in the heart of man. Then by looking at that, the conclusion that you make in your heart is that I am a sinner, I will go to hell. However, God did not work for them according to their request. It's not that God took away all the serpents. However, God now solved that problem through His own way. Then what did he do? Now God commanded Moses. Hey Moses, you make a bronze serpent. You hang it on a pole. So that whoever is bitten by the fire serpent, just by looking at the bronze serpent, they can live. Do you know what happened? So this is what we read in the book of Numbers 21:9. Verse 9 says, so Moses made a bronze serpent and put it on a pole. So it was, if the serpent had bitten anyone, when he looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. Let's read again. So Moses made a bronze serpent and put it on a pole, and so it was, if a serpent had bitten anyone, when he looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. Now, this verse is very amazing. Because it ends saying that anyone he looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. Now this was the way of God. In other words, God was speaking to them. Hey, don't look at the ground. Don't try to avoid the fiery serpents. Why do you stay at the ground? Now raise up your eyes and look at the bronze serpent. When you lift up your eyes and look at the bronze serpent, now you will be healed. People heard this word. However, now that seems to be foolishness. I'm bitten by the fiery serpent, and the poison is really deadly. What do I need in that moment? Oh, I need medication. I need to meet the physician. However, what does Moses say? Just looking at the bronze serpent? Only that. Who has ever overcome the poison of snake by looking? We have never heard such a thing. It doesn't make sense. People were thinking like that. However, now you cannot be healed just by looking at the bronze serpent. However, you are healed by that faith to accept the words of God.
ahubwo kizwa na rya rya jambo rya jambo ryavuzwe.
You are not healed just by looking at the bronze serpent. However, you are healed by receiving the word of God, by believing in it as it is. Because the person who can look at the bronze serpent, it is the person who believes in the word of God. Moses is a servant of God. What Moses says is true. If I look at the bronze serpent, I'll be able to be healed. Now we can say these people, they were healed by faith to believe in the words of God through Moses. In the same way also today, God is asking us not to look at ourselves. Why do you look at yourself? Look at Jesus who was crucified at the cross. If you look at Jesus, then we can overcome the problem of sin. So depending on where you're looking at, that will bring a very big difference in your life. When you read the book of Hebrews chapter 12, I'll just read one scripture in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2.
And Chapter 12, verse 2.
Now the Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God.
Dutumbira Yesu wenyine ari banze ryo kwizera kandi ari we ugusoza rwose yihanganye umusaraba kubw'ibyishimo byamushyizwe imbere yita ku isoni zabo yicara iburyo bw'imbere bw'intebe y'Imana.
How does the Bible say?
Sibiravuga ngo iki?
Looking unto Jesus.
Dutumbira Yesu wenyine.
Don't look at yourself. If you look at yourself, there is a certain faith that will be planted in your heart. Which kind of faith is it? I'm a sinner. I will always be a sinner. I will go to hell. By looking at ourselves, now only condemnation is filled in our heart. However, by looking unto Jesus, the faith of God is made in our heart. Oh, Jesus is crucified for my sin. He has washed away all of my sins. Surely he was paying for the wage of sin. And because of that, now I'm free. Because of that, now I'm righteous. These are people who believe in God. Therefore, the gospel is very simple. However, Satan always tried to lead us astray. When Leonardo da Vinci saw the angel that was confined in the rock, other people were laughing at him. Maybe this person is crazy.
Hey,
what is he talking about? However, his eyes were different from the eyes of normal people. And finally, the angel was talking about, everybody could see him. So I really hope that we look through the eyes of God. When God sees us, He sees us through the blood of Jesus. That's why He says that you are righteous. All of your sins are washed away. Now you are perfect, holy to go to heaven. Then where are you looking at? Don't you really look at yourself? If you look at yourself, you will be like these people who are staring at the ground trying to avoid the snake. Do you think they could really overcome them? Finally, they were beaten. And they died. However, whoever could just look at the bronze serpent hanged on the pole, automatically they were healed. That is our salvation from sin. Look unto Jesus who is crucified at the cross. So here Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. The Bible is telling us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith.
Biravuga ngo dutumbira Yesu wenyine ari we banze ryo kwizera kandi ari we busoza rwose.
Now even after the six salvation.
Nyuma uko twakira agakiza.
What are you looking at?
Se ni ureba.
Many people just look at their disease.
Abantu usanga bareba indwara zabo.
Other people look at their financial problems.
Abantu ukabasanga barareba amikoro make.
Other people just look at their problems.
Abandi bakareba ibibazo byabo.
However, God calls all of those things so that we can change our perspective.
Ariko Imana yemye ibyo byose kugira ngo ihindure intumbero yacu.
In the times of trial,
mu gihe cy'amakuba,
God wants us to look at Jesus.
Imana yashaka ko twitegereza Yesu.
This is why he gave us Jesus.
Imana yaduha Yesu.
Even by giving us the law,
no kuduha amategeko.
God wanted us to look at Jesus.
Imana yashaka ko twitegereza Yesu.
In the book of Galatians, you know, chapter
3, Galatians 3,
the Bible says that, you know, the law was given, you know, until faith comes.
Biravuga ngo amategeko yategetse kugeza ngiye kwizera kwazi.
Therefore, the law was our tutor to take us to Christ Jesus.
Biravuga ngo amategeko ni umushorera wo kutugeza kuri Kristo Yesu.
Now you can see everything was a condition for us to look at Jesus Christ.
Ibyo byose byari ngombwa kugira ngo tubashe gutumbira Yesu.
God wants all the humanity in each and every generation to look at Jesus and be blessed and receive salvation.
Anashako ibinyejana n'ibinyejana buri bose buri bantu bose bazareba Yesu bakamwitegereza bagatsinjiswa nawe.
So I believe that by listening to this one, the blessing that God wants to give you is for you to be able to look unto Jesus. Regardless of any kind of problem or difficulty that you may have, by looking at Jesus, all of your life will be changed. So I believe God will bless you as you receive this word in your heart. Today we'll speak up to here. Allow me to end and pray. Dear our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment. Lord, Satan has deceived us by opening the eyes of the flesh. So each and every time we tend to look at ourselves, then you can only see weakness. We can see our evilness and our sins. But Lord, you want us to look unto Jesus. Because you say that he is the author and the finisher of our faith. In other words, he started the work of salvation and he accomplished it perfectly. Lord, we thank you for this amazing salvation you have given us. Give us grace so that we can value your word. And allow us also to connect other people with this word. Lord, we thank you. We pray all these things in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Rakoze cyane.
So thank you very much. I'll see you next time.
Turasoreza.